Yes, sir. From,
those are hired back.
16. Any comments, gentlemen?
Is that letter being ordered? I'll make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
Yes.
John?
Yes.
I think we'll just jump right up here because.
Fred, I can vote for those.
Oh, you can?
Yes, I can.
PJ?
Yes, I'll vote yes.
Shane, you want just to, we're gonna move you up to the top of the list.
Wow.
Because I know you got important places to go. And important people to see.
Still a seat next to you here. We have the three different township projects on the agenda this evening for the resurfacing projects and the chip seal. Pretty standard fare for what the township has done in the past. You guys presented your multi-year plan, and I think we covered all the bases for 2018. I think the only exception, we took crackle chip seal out to get some of the culvert work done ahead of time, and then we'll get back down there and probably put that in the future round.
We did get together with Manway.
Okay.
And we worked out an agreement with them on capital improvements. Now, Emmerich, I think we told them 3 years.
3 years for hard surface, we're going to go asphalt.
Nice.
So we both have some time to prepare for that. They were in agreement with that. To the best of my knowledge, we did not look at the culvert this year.
Correct. Right. That's going to be a joint project.
We probably need to get on that next year.
We did inspect them and provide a report, so there's information.
On crackle?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, then
so
we'll tend to that next year, and that should be, I think it'll be a good, we did essentially the same agreement that we did with Troy. So that both boundary roads are on the same agreement.
Good.
And so it'd be nice, within 5 years, we should have both of those sections with a paved asphalt surface on them.
Sounds good.
Sounds good.
So on the agenda is the specifications that need your approval, and then the resolutions
right.
for each to authorize the bidding procedures.
You want to just go through these one at a time, and we can sign them, and these are the originals, right?
The original cover for the specs, I'd like
yeah,
to use those for our production side, and then I'll scan them and send a copy back to the township.
What
okay.
We just set for, we'll find out here in a second, bid open.
That one was May 27th? No.
That'll be May 25th, Friday,
May
12:05.
Oh,
we
okay.
receive till 12:10. Start the opening, I believe.
Yes.
Okay, that's
good. Yeah. And then at that, Shane, I believe you said we can have a representative here, but the engineers have handled the opening of those. Or
well, almost. The township is responsible for receiving and opening the bids and reading them. We typically send myself or Nick Gorris to observe and help guide if there's any procedural things that need to happen, but somebody from the township would.
So you don't need a quorum or a full board
nope.
or anything?
No, nope. It's just whoever you guys designate as a authorized representative to receive and open the bids in a public forum at the advertised time.
So it could be Friday even too.
Yep.
I'm sure somebody.
A lot of times it is. We have, you know, Bainbridge Township Service Department does theirs. The Auburn, Chardon Township, one of the trustees typically does it. It could be.
Okay. I'm sure what.
Fiscal officer as well.
Okay.
Do you want me to read through?
Sure. Go ahead. Well, you can just read the subject matter.
Resolution 2017-07, resolution to order the chip seal of various roads in Upper Township.
That'd be 28.
I'm sorry, 2018.
Did we put 2017 on there? For the resolution.
Resolution number 2018-07.
07.
And that's going to be, Bartholomew and,
Thor?
Thor.
Yes. So we might have voted on that.
Okay, I'll make a motion to adopt that resolution, 2018-07.
I'll second. Okay, Mike?
Yes.
PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
And then 2018-08.
Resolution 2018-08, resolution to order the asphalt resurfacing of various roads. And
that one includes Auburn Springs, Widgeon, and Wingate.
Okay.
That bid, that's going to be the same close for bids and then?
Same date, time, it'll be 5 minutes apart, like 12:05, 12:10, 12:15.
Yeah, this one's 12:10, the previous one was 12:15.
Typically, it takes 3 or 4 minutes to open. It's okay to be a few minutes late, we just can't move this.
Be early.
Okay, motion to approve.
Second.
Mike?
Yes.
PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
Next is 2018-09. And that is a resolution for the asphalt resurfacing of sections E and F on Taylor Main Road.
Mund Auburn.
Same date and time for bid openings, 12:05 on this one.
So.
Second.
Mike?
Yes.
PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
Can take these back.
Sure.
And Nancy wanted me to make you promise that you'd send copies back.
Okay, did you sign the resolutions, Fred?
No, not yet.
Thank you.
And a couple that didn't get signed by the fiscal officer, another one that they didn't put the resolution number on, so.
Not for that, right?
Not for here.
Not here, we're on it.
Yep, you're right.
Yeah, so these will open on May 25th. We will collect the bid tabs when the township had a chance to make us a copy, and then what we'll do, we'll collect the bids and put together the bid tabulation, provided that there are no significant errors or anomalies, we would make recommendations to the board to award, and then it's up to you guys to proceed with the.
I do agree with you.
The award, well, to make the award as you see fit, and we'll help the contracts together.
As always, we rely on your expertise.
Thank you, but it's a team effort, working together, so. And then hopefully we'll get these started.
Hopefully we'll be ready to rock and roll in the fourth.
Yeah. So you have a little bit of prep to do, and then we'll be paving and chipping. Any questions?
No, I'm happy. How about you, gentlemen?
I'm ecstatic.
As is usual, we'll send the legal notices to the newspaper on your behalf. They'll send the invoice directly to you, Fred, and then we'll put the specs out for bid and answer any bidding questions during the bid period, and then meet you guys here on the 25th.
Well, some of them don't have it that.
Those are,
what time is it?
Those are
for
new requisitions that Nancy's generating in UAM on her computer.
Okay. So you want,
so that's the requisition that I make a PO for.
You just sit here or there?
Wherever.
Is that the bottom? See, here's the reason.
The preoccupied, all right.
If it's a prank order, you can sign.
Thank you all, have a nice evening.
Have a great night, Shane.
Thank Shane, keeps moving on.
The ones that don't have this bank.
Sorry.
Hell, yeah.
Well, let's go ahead and call for Mr. Kitco.
We all have a copy of the activity for April. We had three agricultural building exemptions, and believe it or not, we had six accessory buildings for this month. Four of them were pretty good, over 200 square feet. So it's a total of nine, and that's all. That's it. We had a couple of people turn in incomplete applications for new homes, so the proposal's still pending, but that's about it, other than been doing a lot of checking on up on Wood Acre Trail, just to see the progress. You know, they, like I said before, we exempted most of it because it's not changing the footprint, but they have been letting us know that they're working and, you know, asked to come up and take a look and everything, so made several trips up there. I did receive, that's all I have in zoning other than this, I received this afternoon, or my office did, from FT and Associates, or the estate of FT and Associates, on the possibility of donating two parcels of land to the township, and one of them is a 5-acre parcel where containing a cell tower on 44, and one of them is 3/4 acre next to the museum, east of the museum.
East of the museum, okay.
And as you all are aware, Mr. Fox died, actually, he died some time ago, but they're trying to close out the estate and everything. And, so Mr. Russo sent this to us today. I haven't had any, of course, any time to look into it. I don't know. I mean, it might be a good deal for us, but there is, I'm sure there's some kind of sewer assessment on both parcels. So.
Yeah, and there'd be taxes.
Right. So,
but this, that's the East Museum. That's the old parsonage or whatever you call it. There was a house there, East of the Museum. Is there anything left there?
I don't think so.
I don't think so. I walked up in there. It's been a while.
And of course, I assume you may, or maybe do not know, that the beverage store is under new ownership. Same people are running it, but the owner has changed, and they have kind of stirred up a little some issues down there that. What Jane and I've been dealing with, and really, there's nothing we can do. But the Boyds had to move their fence. That's been there as long as I can ever remember. And then the parcel just west that shares the same driveway, all of a sudden, they were told they couldn't share the driveway anymore. And I said, well, that's been a shared driveway since I've lived in the township.
Since that house was built.
So I says, I don't know what to, I think maybe they may have worked something out, but the new owner is Mary Lambert. We all know how Mary can be if she wants to be. You know.
I believe that house is the house that KY built.
I believe you're correct, yes. So, that's it.
Is there any other access to the house outside of the common drive?
No.
So it's completely by necessity.
Right, you know, they would have to, you know, be hardship to create a driveway at this stage. Like I said, I've lived here since the 70s, early 70s, and it's been there exactly like it is today, other than...
It's over 21 years, they had first possession.
Open, it has to be notorious, though.
Driving up and down for 21 years, it's been notorious.
Well, there's also a cell tower back there, too. You know, you can't deny the access to the cell tower for a cell company.
That cell tower on the 5 acres, do you know if there's any revenues generated by that? Do you know who's on the tower?
I don't know. I don't know right now. I can do some checking, but like I said, this came in this afternoon, and I didn't know about it till 7:15.
Nancy told me earlier today, and I did get a chance to think about it some, but I don't know anymore than you do. We got to find out what the, well, I see what the evaluations are, but what the tax bills are on those.
Right, right.
You know, we got to have a township purpose to pursue any type of exemption.
Right.
And obviously, the one next to the museum, we could find a purpose for that. We don't have extra space there.
Right.
The other one, I don't know. That'd be up
and I can't, the process. You know, I can't remember whose cell tower it is anymore, you know. If you ask me who's on my road, I can tell you, but I don't know. Chief knows. Chief,
no, I don't.
I don't know either. So, we can check back in the records, but and some of those have changed hands, too, you know, from one carrier to another.
And in taxes, I look at the taxes and the fees, you know, I'll say, $2,500 and a half or something. It wasn't outrageous, but it was still real money.
Yeah.
So if you get enough money out of the cell tower to generate something, but he's like, take care of the sewer system is still like 2025 on that property.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Would you like me to just contact him and tell him we're going to discuss all of this? We're very
we're definitely interested.
Just so we don't want to leave him hanging.
Yeah.
That's,
is there a motion?
That's what the letter would say. We're interested.
I'll second. Yeah.
Mike?
Yes.
PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
I think we got these.
Okay. Report.
Okay, Auburn Township Road Department report for April 2018. The month of April had several light snow events, with only one requiring plowing and or salting. 26 tons of material was used during that event, which brings the new yearly average usage to 1,759. I did supply you guys with the historical data over the last 12 years for every month what we used in average over the last 12 years. There currently is about approximately 300 tons of road salt in our dome. We have 475 tons outstanding to be purchased on the 2017 contract. And Mr. Everly and I did attend a Q meeting there, and I think we came away with wanting to stick with Q, I believe. The contract is up again in September. So I guess we'll review that again.
Well, we did investigate. It was interesting. You know, it was nice to be in a room. There was a lot of members there. Everybody experienced the same delays in getting the salt. I think we've fared very well compared to some of the communities who were still waiting at that time for their order to be processed. But We left there and we investigated to go with the summer salt, which is not open anymore, right, Emma?
Correct.
You know, you're taking, on those contracts, you're just taking your chances. And historically, we've been down within pennies on the price of the salt.
So I discussed it with Emmerich rather in detail. He doesn't feel, I'll speak for Emmerich, but he doesn't feel it's worth trying to change vendors in the mid, you know, we've had very, very good luck with Q. And I think we've been, boy, I'm trying to guess, what would, how many years have we been doing Q? 13, 14?
12 years.
So that's pretty good. Pretty good track record. This was the first year we even had any anomaly, and I really, what I came out of that meeting learning that the delay wasn't anything related to Q. It was related to the vendor. So my thought is we should stay with Q.
And we did delivery on the remaining 475.
Yeah, well, we're already kind of obligated to that, but my thought is that what we would do is they're going to go out for bid for the next year's prices for 19's prices, and let's see what that is. And we're actually going to know for a short window whether 19 is better or worse. So if it's better, we'll go ahead and buy 19 prices. But I my intent and my thinking is that we should go ahead and get 1,900 tons in the bin, in which case we're going to have to rent a conveying system to get the salt up to the very top of the building.
Good.
Now that comes with a little bit of a downside, because depending on the weather, salt can clump together, and you keep digging into the face of the pile, and the pile and your machines, how high can we go, 12 feet?
Stacking currently?
No, with the bucket to knock it, to dig the salt out.
Yeah, not quite 12.
Not quite, probably more like 10 feet. Yeah, well, the salt's up at 17 feet. So that, if it doesn't keep falling down, and of course it doesn't, it creates a bit of a dicey situation to peck away at that salt and get it to come down without falling on the equipment. So,
well, you said, Emmerich, that how he had been stacking it, he had a little bit of a crush problem too, didn't he?
Now, the more you drive over it, the more it turns to powder, and we want granule rather than powder.
I'm all in favor of the conveyor. We've been talking about.
Right, right. And we did, 1 year with Ziegler, we did have him bring his slinger in, and we did utilize his services. It worked out well. That's when we had 1,990 tons, I believe, stacked in there.
You know, according to historical records, that takes care of a year. And we want to just call it an absolute baseline normal year.
Yeah, in the past, we were doing 1,800 tons. But we had a couple winters over 2,000. We went as high as 2,400. With the 20% over, we're able to cover that with the purchase, 20 over, 20 under, 20%. And right now we're standing at 1,759 for your average season. So that is a typical winter where we'd house in the dome. So
we'll have a winter.
How many pounds did we take on the current contract?
The current contract? This one we went 2,000. We'll do 24 on this one. Because the last contract was more expensive, we bought 20% under. So we already anticipated buying the cheaper salt this year. What's left on the 17 contract?
So what's left, we don't have to.
Yeah, and this will bring us out to about 800 tons, just about to the door. And then from that point, we'll be able to stack on top. So,
that's pretty much the ins and outs of the salt pile. And like I said, I never counted, but there had to be 30 municipalities and groups.
Oh, yeah,
there.
At least, right, yeah. And a lot of them did go down to no salt in their dome, and they tried to source out different vendors, but actually in this area here, there's only two people purchased from, so. Coal patching was done several times on various roads with 8 tons of material used. I did put in for one more load, we'll keep that. And if there's a hole here or there, it doesn't justify me going to the asphalt plant and getting a ton to fill something like doing a 5-gallon bucket. We did have one high wind event and one high water event. Trees did come down on Stafford Road and Shaw Road. And we did have the water crest and run over bark on that one, the one event there. Recent signage installed on Eastwood Drive was again removed. They must love that sign. This time they didn't take it, they just threw it in the ditch. Obviously, it must be kids. So we did reinstall that sign. The 33% reduced load limit was released by the Geauga County Commissioners, and the signs were removed on April 30th. Preparations for capital improvement projects began with the saw cutting and pavement for the replacement of cross culvert pipes. We have five of them in our current capital improvement projects that we're going to take care of right away. We have one urn burial at Shadyside, and we did get a jump on there the last couple days to go up in there and start taking care of these graves, topping them, bringing soil in and straightening out the damage that's done there over the course of the winter. We updated our road ratings, and after the update and crunching the data, 82% of our roads still remain in the acceptable surface category, which is really great after this last winter. We had a lot of freeze and thaw cycles. So with that being said, that led us down the path to our crack seal list, which will be put out in the papers on May 17th. And then I believe, I don't have it in front of me, we're gonna do the opening on June 4th. The bids will be received at 4 p.m. on June 4th, and we'll open at that meeting.
We went with the same methodology that we've always done. It's a line item.
Line item, top down, best roads first. And then this way, if we're over our budget, or if we're,
right,
we can take them off as what we did in the past.
Okay. Mr. Troy.
Just one item. Ascot Lane is having their homeowners association, I believe, over at the town hall on Wednesday, and they cordially invited me to come to talk to them and tell them what trustees do.
Oh.
So if the two of you guys could write down what you do, it'd be okay. That's all I have.
Mr. Cap.
The one thing I'm going to have, just to move it along here, is at the township quarterly meeting last month, I sat with both Irene McMullen from Munson Township, and they are going to make an application for NatureWorks grant again. The amount is approximately $46,000 this year. It's a lot higher, and they're going to apply for half of that amount, $23,000. Another municipality is going to apply for the entire thing, and we've been working back and forth. I've been discussing this since we did the playground one too, that the possibility of a, this would be for next year's construction, a pavilion at the park, some shelter outside of the building that we have now.
Mm-hmm.
Nancy's pulled up where we've discussed this in minutes before, and with some of the old maps we had, I know I told her I'm going to come up. If you remember, John, when Tim Olander did
very well,
yeah, okay, so
couldn't
that's
forget him.
And remember, that thing sat the potential development of the park diagram sat back here in the corner for a couple 3 years that I can remember. We're going to find that, just that this works to your benefit that you've been discussing and you've been considering this project for a length of time. So, we're getting all that background together. And really, I guess what I'm bringing up for the board tonight to consider, and we got probably 10 days, 2 weeks before we got to start pulling it together. It's due June 1st. What type of structure? A rectangular pole barn, a circular gazebo. I'm kind of thinking that if we could do something in two phases, even something for the shelter part, and then you and Nancy did the drive arounds looking at shelters, right?
Yes, sir.
So we had that discussion too, and maybe, you know, what's become popular is outdoor cooking stuff that we could add as a second phase, or else do that as a first phase and then add the shelter second. Just kick it around a little bit, and so we can come up with a reasonable application. And per Watershed Partners, who we've worked with before on this, they said, obviously the more, and we know this from road work too, the more communities will benefit from this grant, the better, and the more likelihood of being funded. So I'm not sure how to take that with the municipality that's, you know, applying for 100% of the grant, but she encouraged that we apply for a portion of it. So, that's all.
Okay, Fred?
Just have your regular reports in front of you. Your appropriation summary report, revenue summary report, and fund summary reports. Also, in front of the board are warrants 4459 through 4488, totaling $34,568.93. That's all I've got.
Okay, Maple Shade Restoration. We do have the working plans here, and we have some quotes. Each of you have those there in front of you. We have two different projects, the cemetery restoration, including the plantings and the driveways, and then the creation, the administration project would be creation of the parking lot and concrete walkway in the front here. Changeover, no pine trees, but deciduous trees, and we do have a landscape, a drawing to, I think each of you have a chance to look at the landscape, the drawing to delineate.
Yeah,
they
are. That certainly does make sense, John, to split that out into two different funds to come out of. Fred, did we put enough money in cemetery fund to do that, or do we got to do something?
What is the total on this? So we're looking at $30,562.
Well, that's actually a combined.
Yeah, I think we should have enough in the cemetery fund because we set aside quite a bit of money for restoring that after the trees came down.
You're looking at about 15 or something like that.
Okay.
Say we approve this as cemetery mm-hmm. repairs first.
Sure.
And that looks to me like the right side. Lawn work. I don't know about the lighting. I suppose that could probably apply.
These
over
trees
here.
All go along. Actually, I think you have to view that as the trees kind of border the driveway, BJ. So probably it comes out. One.
Okay. It comes out of administration.
Well, it comes out of the cemetery.
Okay.
And then the administration is the digging of the other quote for the, is to dig the parking lot, move the spoils over into the cemetery.
Yeah, I just saw that.
These do a rough grade, and then for landscaping, they have, they'll do the a final grade when they go ahead and put the trees in.
Okay, and you know, I'm in agreement with all this, but how do you want to break this down as a cemetery administration fight?
I'm looking at the JFD quote as, mm-hmm. as basically a cemetery administration.
Yes, yeah.
In its entirety.
Mm-hmm. Remember, I consider the parking lot really part of the administration.
The administration.
Because that's what we're doing is we're
which
basically
the
taking
the
right.
Estimate.
You're right. That'd be the Parker estimate.
So I'd say basically it's almost to break it down on the dividing line would be like the west side of the existing road.
Yeah.
Because we already have the drive itself is actually part of the cemetery. So anything that happens east of that is the cemetery.
I don't have the map in front of me. It wasn't most of the plannings and everything was going to be
cemetery.
East of
the cemetery, right.
Right. So I think from a financial perspective, I would look at
keep it that way.
JFD as
30,000.
The entire 30,000.
Okay. The entire 30,000.
We may have to use some money from the land improvement fund
mm-hmm.
to go towards that.
No, I don't have a problem with that.
Okay.
I mean, we don't have any big projects scheduled at the park. So.
Yeah, that's a good place to pull it out of then. So it's for.
Actually, I don't know if we're going to do more of the scrubbing of the monuments back here this year. Then I'll make a motion to go with the JFD quote for the, he's got 1, 2, 3, 4 breakdowns here, totaling $30,562.41 for cemetery improvements.
Second.
Mike?
Yes.
PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes. Then, the other thing is to create, we should have, we could blame some of this on the county, maybe they'll want to pay for some of this. We're going to lose our parking in front, so we'll be ripping all that up. Creating a sidewalk from here all the way down the front and to Auburn Road, and then about a 6 foot, I think it is, section over on the 6 or 8 feet on the other side of the road. Because the primary parking is going to probably end up becoming this parking lot. When the road gets moved to where it's going to be moved, and they go with these culvert ditches. I think that's something we're going to have to address as the year goes on, because on a one-on-one conversation with Emmerich and I, we said we don't see how that could happen over there at the town hall. That we're using that, there's no way to put a driveway in. We'd lose a couple spaces because of if there were, you wouldn't have any place to back up to get out of the out. Mm-hmm. Emmerich and I pulled a GIS picture, and it's pretty tight. We thought, well, maybe we could put a drive around the town hall. I don't.
I don't see how you can do that.
No, I don't think
you can. There's not enough space. You don't forget turning radiuses and all of this kind of stuff.
Hey, here's a just a question for you too. Along, it's not exactly related, but do we need a ditch in front of the cemetery down there then too? Adam Hall maybe not, because it's on top of the hill.
Well, as far as the conversations that Mr. Everly and I have had with them, there will be total curb removal.
Mm-hmm. What I heard is they're going to basically, and this is the most Reader's Digest version of it, they're going to cut out 4 feet, 3 to 4 feet of road mm-hmm. on the south side and the curb and dig that all out, mm-hmm. put a ditch there.
Yeah.
Some places that it might even have to be more than that, in my book, to get a good guideline is to drive down there and look at where the telephone poles are, and as a general rule, those are going to sit right on the edge of the road right away. So then you have to start working back towards the middle of the road from that point. And if you're going to create a swale,
When Joe told me that, I'm picturing a ditch coming in front of the cemetery.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Probably not Adam Hall, because...
Well, Adam Hall, there's plenty of space there.
But it sits on top of a hill.
Yeah.
And
so there might
not be one there. It's going to be different.
It's going to be real.
There's going to be a lot of public comment on this once it begins, that's for sure.
Just to give us a little advance notice on exactly what they're doing here.
Well, I do give them credit. That we knew last fall, this when this all started, it all came up, or actually last early fall. Emmerich and I we met with Dave, and they did ditch the north side of the road from one end to the other, and they have all of the sanitary sewers are working on this side. So, one of the things becomes, and it's shown on the drawings, we need to collect any of this runoff water. We don't want any of it coming towards the building. So, we're going to have to take advantage of a swale here. I think that'll be very beneficial to us. And then I don't really think it'll make any difference in the future how high the road ever ends up being if there's a decent swale there and connects to the sanitary sewer. And we've got three outlets to do that. So as far as the grading goes for the parking area, it's going to go north and then go over to Auburn Road. So... we're still going to put a drain, though, a physical drain, so if we have snow piled up, you shouldn't end up with a sheet of ice in the parking lot, in the evening when the sun goes down and any water freezes that wasn't previously melting. So,
okay, so you have a bid from Parker Masonry for this
mm-hmm.
work.
He's actually going to sub some of that work out to, Dave Wagner.
So he's general contractor, though.
But Parker will be responsible for everything.
Okay, remove existing parking lot south side of building, cut the subgrade and prep. For asphalt lot east of the building, install 100 feet of concrete curb along east side of building, install a catch basin in the parking lot, grade and prepare cemetery drive for paving, install new concrete sidewalk and entrance to new door. Estimated labor and materials, $47,850.
The new door being that door in the back, of which we would probably replace that door, and that would become an actual functional handicapped entrance.
Okay, I'll make
maybe
a motion.
Maybe at the same time we'll put a fob on that door.
Okay, I will make a motion on that.
Okay, motion to accept estimate for 4700. Park and Mason. Can I get a second?
Second.
Mike?
Yes.
PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
We do I see Nancy didn't put this together for you, and I'll have it for you together at the next, since they actual cost to hire Todd Lamb to apply the asphalt. I think for both projects, it's less than $10,000. He brings how many men? Three men. So
once again, you probably split some of that out as a cemetery.
Right. The bulk of that actually will be the cemetery. That's 80% is all the cemetery work. Because that's the cemetery drive.
Which we lost in that storm. Yeah. I mean, it's
sad part is insurance won't cover that.
I know. No, insurance does not cover roads. They're real clear on that.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Real clear.
Even though a tree tore up the road.
Not a real clear.
Well, they didn't cover trees either. So, but hey, sometimes, you know, Mother Nature deals you a little blow there that 30 seconds was that? Mm-hmm.
So we just going to encumber the...
Well, I think we'll just handle him. He's the second. We'll handle that at the next meeting. I did get those numbers. I have them all. Nancy has them, and apparently she didn't get a chance to summarize those for you.
Oh, I think a couple of weeks are still pretty tight.
Yeah, we'll be
that,
fine on so. That. I had discussed with JFD and... Parker, that we'd like to have this course all completed sometime here by October for this winter, the fall planting season, and that seems to be pretty doable. So, okay, that should take care of those items. Township welcome signs.
We had a meeting with the Welcome Sign Committee meeting, and we reviewed the latest designs from Epic Design, and we came up with basically two designs that we really liked. One of them has a kind of faux wood background on it, sort of a more rustic look to it, but with the actual face of the sign would be something a little bit. It would be, you know, kind of a mixture of something formal and rustic. You'd have to see it to kind of really understand it. But we are asking for another drawing of that. We also got in contact with we looked at another sign company. We weren't really too happy with what they were proposing. It was basically just vinyl application. And that's not really the direction that we wanted to go. And so we did, though, get in contact with a third vendor, and we're going to meet with him tomorrow, and this is the gentleman that did South Russell's signs, and he's done a lot of work for Cedar Point and some other companies. He's got really creative, nice-looking stuff in his portfolio. So we're going to talk to him tomorrow and just see if he can give us a proposal so we've got at least three proposals to look at
okay.
and consider.
Good.
So that's where we're at.
Good. Thank you.
Yeah, I appreciate you guys looking at this because we're going to be stuck with these for a long time.
Hopefully, yeah.
The last one stayed up for 40 some years.
I hope the word isn't stuck, but...
The last one stayed up for 40 years, so...
You know, the other thing, too, is we were considering maybe doing only... instead of doing all 10 signs that we originally proposed to do, maybe doing a number less than that so that we can get maybe some nicer signs for the budget
mm-hmm.
and maybe complete that next year with the balance of things. So.
Oh, that's not a bad idea.
You know, it just depends on what we come up with for final estimates. See if we're going to be in budget.
Okay. Memorial Day. I just, anything on that, DJ?
Pretty much falling into place now. We did a couple of proposed, agenda's not the word, program, and ran it past the Veterans Committee, and we made a couple of changes. We're going to start at Adam Hall, the official public part of the program, at 9 a.m. So will not be here this year. Probably one time only, but time will tell. It's going to be 9 a.m. at Adam Hall. And then we will proceed. We're going to have the sheriff close the road as they have before, but they're going to close it at Messenger down to 44 to get everybody up there. Should work. I think it should work just fine. I do.
They're driving to the cemetery.
We're just going to drive to the cemetery. There's some discussion they had about a parade. We discovered that's about 0.6 miles.
Some of us can't go 0.6.
Yeah, which that's quite a bit longer than this little stretch here, so I think the parade is on the shelf for this year. But, you know, everything else that we've had in the past will be incorporated into this, and there's going to be a private sort of laying of the wreath here by the Veterans Committee over here at the mound at the bell here. Probably prior, but that's not actually going to be part of the ceremony, but it will be an official part of what the committee's going to do. So,
I had something I would like to throw into this. Probably for at least 30 years that I can remember that I've been coming to this event. Auburn family has come out and put flags at all the military graves.
The Gauls.
And that's the Gauls. And I would like to have our board make a proclamation to be read at the cemetery to thank them. I don't think there's any, in the words of Bob Gaul, to me, last year, as long as there's a Gaul, we'll be putting these flags up.
That's what
you know, this is not an easy look. You know, this isn't something you run in here and do in 2 minutes.
Well, Jackie comes down from Vermont.
Exactly. And they all have a family get together, but they spend the bulk of that time putting up flags in the cemetery, which I think is well deserving of a nice proclamation. I would hope we could maybe surprise them with it at that ceremony. What you guys think?
Great idea.
Yeah, and maybe there was a couple of stories done about the family last year. I think Joni wrote one.
Mm-hmm.
Joni Demersion, and I'm not sure if Diane.
Well, maybe we could. We might step up and get a little fancier mm-hmm. than our standard proclamation, but it might be nice for 30 years worth of.
I think
service to the township. I'll work with Nancy to get that written up and handled. Okay. Large item pickup is going to be May 31st. And first, you must call the Department on Aging and register. And they will give the names to Emmerich, hopefully not the day before. And Emmerich will create the routes and so we can do it in the most efficient manner. And then that brings us to large item pickup day, and we have to discuss the fees.
How about that? Let me just propose some fees. I would suggest a car and small truckload at $7, a full-size truckload at $10, tires on and off rims, limit 8 per household, I know you can't haul any more than eight per pickup truck.
You can't carry more than eight.
Yeah, you can't carry more than eight, so limit eight. No charge, because we get a grant for that, and for years. Proof of residency required, cash or checks accepted. No liquids, paint, rocks, yard waste, household garbage, or hazardous waste will be accepted. All small materials shall be consolidated in strong boxes or containers. Unbroken car batteries will be accepted. How's that sound?
And it's at Animal.
I was wondering if the board might consider just raising everything to $10.
Make it easier?
It's a lot easier to change when it's tight.
The only thing
it's
that
the one thing we do.
One thing that we don't talk on here is like the clown that showed up with the U-Haul truck that was filled to the roof.
You're gonna have one every year.
Yeah, every year.
And
insisted that he just had one or two things in it.
Yeah, you're going to have one of those every year. I don't know what you do to ban those.
Well, you just charge them more money, that's all.
I'll be honest with you. I'd rather eliminate the fees than raise the fees. But if you don't put fees on there...
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
I'll be here for a month.
So I like... I keep it as minimal as I can. That's what I would think.
I mean, right now we subsidize this as a...
Yeah, well, it's... Why not? There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. It's a valuable service, otherwise this stuff ends up out in the woods or in the ditch. So, there's no township dump anymore. Used to be.
There was?
Yes, there was. Frank's Road. Yeah. Remember that?
A real one?
No comment.
Yeah, I'm sure the driveway's still there. Yeah.
I think we make a motion that Fred goes to the bank and... It's a bunch of $1 bills, so we can continue our fee structure.
We could go $5 on cars.
I'm okay with that. You can't eliminate them for... There's some obvious reason to eliminate them.
I think it's looking like 2-1 here, and I'll just go to the bank and get money.
Motion to...
Big change.
That was a motion you made. I'll second your motion. Right?
Motion to
move things
continue
along.
With the same
structure.
We've had that for the last at least 7 or 8 years.
And it's all right. It's something that provides a service, and that's stuff we should do. So,
So it's PJ, John seconds. Mike?
Yes.
PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
Okay. Now, confirming the time, you said there was an event at Adam Hall. We were talking about changing the time to noon.
Well, I don't know how early we want. I mean,
you want to start an hour earlier? Is what you're. But typically, we start receiving at 8, but they're lined up.
They're lined up at 7:15, 7:30 sometimes.
Well, if they're lined up at 7 o'clock anyway, and when we learn at the 1 o'clock, they end up going until 2 o'clock anyway, it might make more sense to just do 7 to noon.
Okay. From 7 to noon?
Right. So that means you're going to have to get there at 6 for the early birds.
Well, they get there at 6:30. I mean, that's not a problem.
But one of those paper ticket machines.
Yeah, right.
If anybody, we can go like at the License Bureau and get one of those.
No serving.
Yeah.
All right, I just wanted to confirm that. So I think that makes the most sense. Just get in. You're right. Everybody's there early anyway. And this way we can, if we cut it off at noon, maybe we're out there.
Line.
It's an exciting thing. It's like Christmas morning.
Well, Fred's
trying to be the Grinch about it, make it look like
paper. Emmerich, we also had...
I'm excited for it.
At the roadside cleanup day, the leader, one of the... I can't think what you call him now, in the Boy Scouts.
Scoutmaster?
No, it wasn't the Scoutmaster. It was one of the leaders of the... Offered that they would, could we use some help from them from some couple of scouts, the older scouts. And I was thinking, yeah, we could use them to come in and help queue traffic.
Probably Mr. Mast.
That'd probably be, yeah, I don't know about handling stuff.
Not handling stuff, but I'd say just...
No, that would probably be Collins.
I mean, just get a couple of front, you know, wave of the traffic around, see a couple of vests.
So we would, we could, I told him we'd, you know, maybe talk about it, but I thought it'd be acceptable.
Yeah.
Acceptable, yeah, great.
Yeah, the vests and flags.
Yeah, we would need those.
We'd supply that, yeah.
Right.
Would help, yeah.
They have them collect money and make change so Fred doesn't whine.
There you go, and I can go and sit under an umbrella while they do it.
Oh, that's my job.
My son's in scouts, I can make him do it.
See, this is working out.
Yeah, okay, so we're gonna go at 7 to noon.
7 to noon.
And we've got our fee schedule. We've got some helpers coming in.
Okay.
All right?
Mm-hmm. So you want me to contact the...
You want to contact, if you're gonna see them, they're gonna use them?
Yeah.
Well, these are Boy Scouts.
Mm-hmm.
The oldest ones, not the youngest.
You know, along the same lines here too, Fred, I don't think anybody did it in the report because it's been a couple weeks out now, but we want to thank both the Boy Scouts and the Cub Scouts and the Girl Scout troop that helped out with cleanup day too. It was a pretty,
yeah, went a
pretty good turnout.
They had a nice turnout. There's, of all groups were there, including the 4-H kids were there.
That's right.
And how much did you, would you say, I mean, we don't have a 40-yard dumpster of stuff, but we still have
it. A 15, yeah, it was pretty full.
Pretty
yeah.
full dumpster.
You consider all that stuff is on the side of the road, that's a lot.
That is.
Yeah.
And so I think it was a nice community service day for those.
These kids all seemed to have a good time when they came back. And
the weather was good, so we didn't have snow this year, so.
They found a case of Pepsi and my son tried to drink some of it.
Pepsi.
We're supposed to clean up the roads.
That'll be right here next to the popcorn machine.
Yes, we did pop popcorn. okay, so that takes care of that. Some new business, 2018 Care Works, they're our managed care organization. Fred, you deal with them?
Yeah, it's open enrollment time for
right.
MCOs, and Care Works is, it's the largest MCO in the state, and it's also recommended or endorsed, I should say, by the Ohio Township Association. We've been working with them for a long time. So I would just ask that we be able to continue to work with them. They seem to be doing a decent job.
You have a motion?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we stay with Care Works.
Second.
And the other part of that
is vote.
Mike?
Vote.
Oh, yes. PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
They are also our third-party administrator.
Yes.
Which means that not only do they handle the reporting, but they also consult with us and they send representatives to Industrial Commission hearings for workers' comp claims. So they've done a good job. They did a good job this past year. We had a claim that they handled for us. So I would recommend that we continue to work with them as our third-party administrator as well.
Okay. Anything else on that?
I can get a motion.
You'll second that.
Oh, I thought we could. Is that going to time warp or what?
No, I'll make the motion. If everyone's on a motion, got another motion.
And now you got a second say. Thank you.
It's two motions.
Two motions.
Mike?
Yes.
PJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
I thought we did that already. You did one for the MCO.
Oh.
But it's two separate
contracts. You might have tried the second guys. Okay. We've got our requisition. Emmerich, you've got some culvert pipes?
Yes, sir. They should be in there for it.
Yeah. Do you want anything you want to enumerate on those?
Oh, well, these are the pipes that are scheduled for our capital improvement project, cross culvert replacement pipes. We did review with the engineers each cross culvert pipe that does happen to exist within the limits of these projects. And they do hand down the recommendations for us as to change these out, which is what we're doing.
Okay, all right.
And we did on Taylor May have a couple that they're going to consider now or then, which the next surface for that section of Taylor May will tackle those as well.
Now, this is my statement. We're going to go with HDPE pipes. They're less expensive, they are easier to install. And what we went back.
HDPE.
High-density polyethylene.
We're batting 100% on those.
Right, the ones that we've installed in the past, we do keep tabs on them. We look if there's any type of buoyancy issues at the inlet and outlets of the pipe. Everything that we have installed over the last 10 years, I believe, when we start putting these pipes in, they're still intact, they're still in place. They have the same life cycle as well, 50-year life cycle, as with the concrete as well.
So we will continue with that, and hopefully we'll we've got some address. Then once we get those things banged out, we're going to address a couple of residential driveway pipes that have been hanging here for a couple of years, and one on Quinn and one on
Quinn, Cumberland, and Curry.
Yeah. So those are the others are smaller, but all right. Township website update.
I know Nancy's been talking. We've been with this Mallory Taylor doing our website for, I think, like 10 or 12 years now, which seems impossible, but it's true.
You didn't have computers 12 years ago.
Yeah. Nancy's been talking to them for at least a month, maybe two, and they put together some proposals here, and she expressed a willingness to come to a meeting. It might be a good idea to do that.
Yeah, I met with Nancy and Mallory last week, and yeah, she did a good demonstration of improvements that we can make to the site. And one of the things that we definitely need to improve is making it more dynamic, because when you put that site on different size screens, it doesn't come across very well. Like, if you try to look at it on your phone, it becomes really tiny, hard to read. And so she's got some ideas for making that look across platforms a little bit better.
And she is willing to come out and give us a little show on that.
I think so.
That'd be good.
Yeah, I'd like to see that, see what we get for our money.
It's been 10 years, so early time.
Okay, that's everything. Anything else? Comments? Yeah.
Yes, a couple of things. First off, there was a reference to Harper, $47,850. Was there anybody else that got interviewed or expressed an interest in that particular project?
Yes, we did go to several people.
Okay. And so Harper was
by
the lowest and best? Okay. And the second question regards the last meeting. There was an executive session regarding a piece of land, a possible sale, and I wonder if there's possibility of having an update on that.
Well, right now, there's really nothing going on with it. Been discussions of purchasing the selling of land. We haven't had a specific offer of monetary value. Prices that are discussed, it's at least the board isn't really considering it right now.
Okay.
The offers that were made, there's no real reason for us to get rid of that property.
That's correct.
Okay, this wasn't concerning Gennardo, was it?
Well, he's been wanting to swap the properties.
Yeah, right.
And then we said we're not interested in swapping the properties, you know, make us an offer if you want to buy them, and so
okay,
right now,
so
the
basically way there was a conversation, but it's sort of
there were several reasons to not swap properties. Probably one at the top of the list was we have a tax exemption on that piece down there now,
mm-hmm.
which we just used last year for storage of road equipment
mm-hmm.
for quite a spell. We'd lose that if we swapped. So what was sent back to the party was that we'd be making an offer. And he made an offer, and it's really not in the ballpark.
And again, it's, you know, tell us what, you know, how whatever you're doing is going to benefit Auburn Township.
Yeah.
As we've been asking for years. And you come up and say, yes, this is going to happen, that's going to happen, we're going to do this, and haven't heard anything to that effect to sway me from just keeping the property.
Okay.
Personal opinion.
Any other motions, gentlemen?
Well, if there's no other questions, I will make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Mike?
Yes.
BJ?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
Don't forget to vote tomorrow.
They're busy up there tonight.
Take care.
Yes, you too.